Roman Arkadyevich Abramovich, Hebrew, born the 24th of October 1966, is a Russian-Israeli billionaire businessman and politician. Abramovich is the primary owner of the private investment company Millhouse LLC, and is best known outside Russia as the owner of Chelsea FC, a Premier League football club. He was formerly governor of Chukotka Autonomous Okrug from 2000 to 2008. According to Forbes, Abramovich's net worth was $12.9 billion in 2019, making him the second richest person in Israel, 11th richest in Russia, and the 113th richest person in the world. He has donated more money than any other living Russian, with donations between the years 1999 and 2013 of more than $2.5 billion to build schools, hospitals and infrastructure in Chukotka. Abramovich has been labeled an oligarch by his critics. Chapter 1, Personal Life. Chapter 1, Section 1, Family. Abramovich's family is Jewish and are originally from Tauridž, Lithuania, with the Lithuanian spelling of the family name being Abramovicius. His father Arkady Abramovich was a state office manager, while his grandfather Naim Abramovich was a businessman. Naim Abramovich was born in Ertsvilkas, Lithuania, and his wife, Torba, was born in Džiugas, Lithuania. They were married in Tauridž, Lithuania in 1925. During the first Soviet occupation of Lithuania, the family and their children were sent to Siberia as victims of the June deportation. Spouses found themselves in different carriages and lost each other. Abramovich's grandfather, Naim, died in Gulag Camp Reshoti in 1942. Abramovich's mother was Irina Mykolenko. Having lost both parents before the age of four, Abramovich was raised by relatives and spent much of his youth in the Komi Republic in northern Russia. Abramovich is the chairman of the Federation of Jewish Communities of Russia, a trustee of the Moscow Jewish Museum, and donates money to the Chabad movement. Abramovich has been married and divorced three times. In December 1987, following a brief stint in the Soviet Army, he married Olga Yurovna Lysova. They divorced in 1990. In October 1991, he married a former Russian Aeroflot stewardess, Irina Malandina. They have five children: Ilya, Irina, Sofia, Arkady, and Anna. The couple divorced in 2007. On the 15th of October 2006, the News of the World reported that Irina had hired two top UK divorce lawyers, following reports of Abramovich's close relationship with the then 25-year-old Dasha Zhukova, daughter of a prominent Russian oligarch, Alexander Zhukov. It was speculated that a future divorce settlement might be the highest ever on record. The Abramovichs replied that neither had consulted attorneys at that point. However, they later divorced in Russia in March 2007, with a reported settlement of $300 million. Abramovich married Zhukova in 2008, and they have two children, a son, Aaron Alexander, and a daughter, Leah Lou. In August 2017, the couple announced that they would separate, and their divorce was finalized in 2018. Chapter 2, Early Career. Abramovich entered the business world during his army service. Abramovich first worked as a street trader, and then as a mechanic at a local factory. At the peak of perestroika, Abramovich sold imported rubber ducks from his Moscow apartment. Abramovich attended the Gubkin Institute of Oil and Gas in Moscow, then traded commodities for the Swiss trading firm Runicom. In 1988, as perestroika opened up opportunities for privatization in the Soviet Union, Abramovich got a chance to legitimize his old business. He and Olga set up a company making dolls. Within a few years, his wealth spread from oil conglomerates to pig farms. He has traded in timber, sugar, foodstuffs and other kinds of products. In 1992, he was arrested and sent to prison in a case of theft of government property. Chapter 2, Section 1, Friendship with Boris Berezovsky. According to two different sources, Abramovich first met Berezovsky either at a meeting with the Russian businessman, in 1993 or in the summer of 1995. Berezovsky and Abramovich registered an offshore company, Runicom Limited, with five subsidiaries. Abramovich headed the Moscow affiliate of the Swiss firm, Runicom SA. In August 1995, Boris Yeltsin decreed the creation of Sibneft, which Abramovich and Berezovsky were thought to be top executives of. Chapter 2, Section 2, Acquisition of Sibneft, Loans for Shares, and Aluminium Wars. In 1995, Abramovich and Berezovsky acquired a controlling interest in the large oil company Sibneft. The deal took place within the controversial Loans for Shares program, and each partner paid $100 million for half of the company, above the stake's stock market value of $150 million at the time, and rapidly turned it up into billions. The fast rising value of the company led many observers, in hindsight, to suggest that the real cost of the company should have been in the billions of dollars. Abramovich later admitted in court that he paid billions of dollars of bribes to government officials and gangsters to acquire and protect his assets. As of 2000, Sibneft annually produced $3 billion worth of oil. The Times claimed that he was assisted by Badri Patarkatsishvili in the acquisition of Sibneft. After Sibneft, Abramovich's next target was the aluminium industry. After privatization, the aluminium wars led to murders of smelting plant managers, metals traders and journalists as groups battled for control of the industry. Abramovich was initially hesitant to enter into the aluminium business, claiming that every 3 days, someone was murdered in that business. Chapter 2, Section 3, Relationship with Boris Berezovsky and Badri Patarkatsishvili. In 2011, a transcript emerged of a taped conversation that took place between Abramovich and Berezovsky at Le Bourget Airport in December 2000. Badri Patarkatsishvili, a close acquaintance of Berezovsky, was also present and secretly had the conversation recorded. During the discussion, Berezovsky spoke of how they should legalize their aluminium business, and later claimed in court that he was an undisclosed shareholder in the aluminium assets and that legalization in this case meant to make his ownership official. In response, Abramovich states in the transcript that they cannot legalize because the other party in the 50-50 joint venture would need to do the same, in a supposed reference to his business partner Oleg Deripaska. Besides Deripaska, references are made to several other players in the aluminium industry at the time that would have had to legalize their stake. Abramovich's lawyers later claimed that legalization meant structuring protection payments to Berezovsky to ensure they complied with Western antimony laundering regulations. The Times also notes, Mr. Abramovich discloses that there was a showdown at St. Moritz Airport in Switzerland in 2001 when Mr. Patarkatsishvili asked him to pay $1.3 billion to Mr. Berezovsky. The defendant agreed to pay this amount on the basis that it would be the final request for payment by Mr. Berezovsky and that he and Mr. Patarkatsishvili would cease to associate themselves publicly with him and his business interests. The payment was duly made. Mr. Abramovich was also willing to pay off Mr. Patarkatsishvili. He states that he agreed to pay $585 million by way of final payment. Mr. Abramovich denies that he helped himself to Mr. Berezovsky's interests in Sibneft and aluminium, or that he threatened a friend of the exile. It is denied that Mr. Abramovich made or was party to the alleged explicit or implicit coercive threats or intimidation, he states. According to court papers submitted by Abramovich, Abramovich mentions in the court papers, prior to the August 1995 decree, the defendant informed Mr. Berezovsky that he wished to acquire a controlling interest in Sibneft on its creation. In return for the defendant agreeing to provide Mr. Berezovsky with funds he required in connection with the cash flow of ORT, Mr. Berezovsky agreed he would use his personal and political influence to support the project and assist in the passage of the necessary legislative steps leading to the creation of Sibneft. Mr. Patarkatsishvili did provide assistance to the defendant in the defendant's acquisition of assets in the Russian aluminium industry. Chapter 2, Section 4, Investments in Technology. In 2015, Abramovich invested and led a $30 million round of funding with businessman ɐrˈkadʲjɪvʲɪtɕ, chairman of PER Equities. Other partners include several well-known people from the music industry, among them David Guetta, Nicki Minaj, Tiesto, Avicii, will.i.am, Benny Anderson, Dave Holmes and others. Abramovich has invested in other startups in various fields. Among them is Brainc, an Israeli startup which develops artificial intelligence-powered technologies to treat neurological disorders, such as stroke, spinal cord injury, and traumatic brain injury. Also Store. Founded by Doron Meyerstorf, where Abramovich has invested over $30 million. Chapter 3 – Relationship with Russian Leaders. Chapter 3 – Section 1 – Boris Yeltsin. By 1996, at the age of 30, Abramovich had become close to President Boris Yeltsin, and had moved into an apartment inside the Kremlin at the invitation of the Yeltsin family. In 1999, the 33-year-old Abramovich was elected governor of the Russian province of Chukotka. He ran for a second term as governor in 2005. The Kremlin press service reported that Abramovich's name had been sent for approval as governor for another term to Chukotka's local parliament, which confirmed his appointment on the 21st of October 2005. Chapter 3, Section 2, Vladimir Putin. Abramovich was the first person to originally recommend to Yeltsin that Vladimir Putin be his successor as the Russian president. When Putin formed his first cabinet as prime minister in 1999, Abramovich interviewed each of the candidates for cabinet positions before they were approved. Subsequently, Abramovich would remain one of Putin's closest confidants. In 2007, Putin consulted in meetings with Abramovich on the question of who should be his successor as president. Medvedev was personally recommended by Abramovich. Chris Hutchins, a biographer of Putin, describes the relationship between the Russian president and Abramovich as like that between a father and a favorite son. Abramovich himself says that when he addresses Putin, he uses the Russian language is formal, as opposed to the informal. Abramovich says that the reason is he is more senior than me. Within the Kremlin, Abramovich is referred to as Mr. A. In September 2012, the High Court Judge Elizabeth Gloucester said that Abramovich's influence on Putin was limited. There was no evidential basis supporting the contention that Mr. Abramovich was in a position to manipulate, or otherwise influence, President Putin, or officers in his administration, to exercise their powers in such a way as to enable Mr. Abramovich to achieve his own commercial goals. Abramovich is one of many Russian oligarchs named in the Countering America's Adversaries Through Sanctions Act, SARSAR, signed into law by President Donald Trump in 2017. Chapter 4 – Political Career. Chapter 4, Section 1 – Duma Member. In 1999, Abramovich was elected to the State Duma as the representative for the Chukotka Autonomous Okrug, an impoverished region in the Russian Far East. He started the charity Pole of Hope to help the people of Chukotka, especially children, and in December 2000, was elected governor of Chukotka, replacing Alexander Nazarov. Chapter 4, Section 2, Governor. Abramovich was the governor of Chukotka from 2000 to 2008. It is believed that he invested over $1.3 billion in the region. Under Abramovich, living standards improved, schools and housing were restored and new investors were being drawn to the region. Abramovich was awarded the Order of Honor for his huge contribution to the economic development of the Autonomous District, by a decree signed by the President of Russia. Chapter 4, Section 2, Subsection 2, Resignation. In early July 2008, it was announced that President Dmitry Medvedev had accepted Abramovich's request to resign as governor of Chukotka, although his various charitable activities in the region would continue. In the period 2000 to 2006, the average salaries in Chukotka increased from about $165 per month in 2000 to $826 per month in 2006. Chapter 5, Controversies. Chapter 5, Section 1, Boris Berezovsky Allegations. In 2011, Berezovsky brought a civil case against Abramovich, called Berezovsky v. Abramovich, in the High Court of Justice in London, accusing Abramovich of blackmail, breach of trust and breach of contract, and seeking over £3 billion in damages. On the 31st of August, 2012, the High Court dismissed the lawsuit. The High Court judge stated that because of the nature of the evidence, the case hinged on whether to believe Berezovsky or Abramovich's evidence. The judge found Berezovsky to be an unimpressive and inherently unreliable witness, who regarded truth as a transitory, flexible concept, which could be molded to suit his current purposes, whereas Abramovich was seen as a truthful, and on the whole, reliable witness. Chapter 5, Section 2, Bribery. In 2008, The Times reported that court papers showed Abramovich admitting that he paid billions of dollars for political favors and protection fees for shares of Russia's oil and aluminium assets. Chapter 5, Section 3, Allegations of Loan Fraud. An allegation emerging from a Swiss investigation links Roman Abramovich, through a former company, and numerous other Russian politicians, industrialists and bankers to using a $4.8 billion loan from the IMF as personal slush fund. An audit sponsored by the IMF itself determined that all of the IMF funds had been used appropriately. In January 2005, the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development indicated that it would be suing Abramovich over a £9 million loan. The EBRD said that it is owed $17.5 million by Runicom, a Switzerland-based oil trading business which had been controlled by Abramovich and Eugene Schuedler. Abramovich's spokesman indicated that the loan had previously been repaid. Chapter 5, Section 4, Antitrust Law Violation in Russia. Russia's antitrust body, the Federal Anti-Monopoly Service, claimed that Evraz Holding, owned in part by Abramovich, had breached Russian competition law by offering unfavorable terms for contractors and discriminating against domestic consumers for coking coal, a key material used in steel production. Chapter 5, Section 5, Dispute with Kolomoyskaya. According to Putin, Abramovich has been cheated by Ukrainian Cypriot Israeli oligarch Igor Kolomoyskaya. Putin claimed in 2014 that Kolomoyskaya had reneged on a contract with Abramovich, saying that the pair signed a multi-billion dollar deal on which Kolomoyskaya never delivered. Chapter 5, Section 6, FinCEN Files and Funding Jewish Settlements in Palestine. An investigation by BBC News Arabic has found that Russian oligarch Roman Abramovich controls companies that have donated $100 million to an Israeli settler organization, the Ir David Foundation, that operates in East Jerusalem. By allowing settlement activity in the area, Israel is considered to be in breach of international law. Israel disputes this view. Analysis of bank documents has revealed that Chelsea Football Club's owner, Abramovich, is the biggest single donor to the organization. The bank documents, known as the FinCEN files, were leaked to BuzzFeed News, then shared with the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists and the BBC. Elod also runs the City of David and other archaeological sites, visited by a million tourists each year in Jerusalem. Palestinians claim that Israel is breaking international law by allowing exploratory archaeological digs to be carried out in occupied land. Chapter 6, European Football. Chapter 6, Section 1, Chelsea FC. In June 2003, Abramovich became the owner of the companies that control Chelsea Football Club in West London. The previous owner of the club was Ken Bates, who went on to buy Leeds United. Chelsea immediately embarked on an ambitious program of commercial development, with the aim of making it a worldwide brand on a par with footballing dynasties such as Manchester United and Real Madrid, and also announced plans to build a new state-of-the-art training complex in Cobham, Surrey. Since the takeover, the club has won 16 major trophies, the UEFA Champions League, the UEFA Europa League twice, the Premier League five times, the FA Cup five times, and the League Cup three times, making Chelsea the second most successful English trophy-winning team in the decade with 16 honours, behind only Manchester United with 17 honours in the same time span. His tenure has also been marked by rapid turnover in managers, who can be fired if they do not bring immediate success and maintain it. Detractors has used the term Chelsea semi-affectionately to refer to the new Chelsea under Abramovich, to highlight the modern phenomenon of billionaires buying football clubs and purchasing trophies, by using their personal wealth to snap up marquee players at will, distorting the transfer market, citing the acquisition of Andriy Shevchenko for a then British record transfer fee of around £30 million in the year ending June 2005. Chelsea posted record losses of £140 million and the club was not expected to record a trading profit before 2010, although this decreased to reported losses of £80.2 million in the year ending June 2006. In a December 2006 interview, Abramovich stated that he expected Chelsea's transfer spending to fall in years to come. UEFA responded to the precarious profit/loss landscape of clubs, some owned by billionaires, but others simply financial juggernauts like Real Madrid, with financial fair play regulations. Chelsea finished their first season after the takeover in second place in the Premier League, up from fourth the previous year. They also reached the semi-finals of the Champions League, which was eventually won by surprise contender Porto, managed by Jose Mourinho. For Abramovich's second season at Stamford Bridge, Mourinho was recruited as the new manager, replacing the incumbent Claudio Ranieri. Chelsea ended the 2004-05 season as league champions for the first time in 50 years and only the second time in their history. Abramovich is present at nearly every Chelsea game and shows visible emotion during matches, a sign taken by supporters to indicate a genuine love for the sport, and usually visits the players in the dressing room following each match. This stopped for a time in early 2007, when press reports appeared of a feud between Abramovich and manager Mourinho regarding the performance of certain players, notably Andriy Shevchenko. On 1 July 2013, Chelsea celebrated 10 years under Abramovich's ownership. Before the first game of the 2013-14 season against Hull City on 18 August 2013, the Russian thanked Chelsea supporters for 10 years of support in a short message on the front cover of the match programme, saying, "We have had a great decade together and the club could not have achieved it all without you. Thanks for your support and here's to many more years of success." In March 2017, Chelsea announced it had received approval to for a revamped £500 million stadium at Stamford Bridge with a capacity of up to 60,000. On 15 July 2018, the renewal of Abramovich's British visa by the Home Office, and his subsequent withdrawal of the application, in May 2018 Chelsea halted plans to build a £500 million stadium in southwest London due to the unfavourable investment climate, and the lack of assurances about Abramovich's immigration status. Abramovich was set to invest hundreds of millions of pounds for the construction of the stadium. Abramovich has been accused of purchasing Chelsea at the behest of Vladimir Putin, but he denies this. In 2021, Abramovich was criticized for trying to enter Chelsea into unpopular European Super League. The competition has been widely scrutinized for encouraging greediness among the richer, larger football clubs, which undermines the significance of existing football competitions. However, just 2 days later, Abramovich decided to pull the club out of the new competition, with other English clubs following suit. Chapter 6, Section 2, CSKA Moscow. In March 2004, Sibneft agreed to a 3-year sponsorship deal worth €41.3 million with the Russian team CSKA Moscow. Although the company explained that the decision was made at management level, some viewed the deal as an attempt by Abramovich to counter accusations of being unpatriotic which were made at the time of the Chelsea purchase. UEFA rules prevent one person owning more than one team participating in UEFA competitions, so Abramovich has no equity interest in CSKA. A lawyer, Alexandra Gareze, is one of his partners in CSKA. Following an investigation, Abramovich was cleared by UEFA of having a conflict of interest. Nevertheless, he was named most influential person in Russian football in the Russian magazine Pro Sport at the end of June 2004. In May 2005, CSKA won the UEFA Cup, becoming the first Russian club ever to win a major European football competition. In October 2005, however, Abramovich sold his interest in Sibneft and the company's new owner Gazprom, which sponsors Zenit St. Petersburg, cancelled the sponsorship deal. Chapter 6, Section 3, Russian National Team. Abramovich also played a large role in bringing Hus Hiddink to Russia to coach the Russia national football team. Pete Devisa, a former head scout of Hiddink's club PSV Eindhoven and now a personal assistant to Abramovich at Chelsea, recommended Hiddink for the Chelsea owner. Chapter 6, Section 4, National Academy of Football. In addition to his involvement in professional football, Abramovich sponsors a foundation in Russia called the National Academy of Football. The organization sponsors youth sports programs throughout the country and has constructed more than 50 football pitches in various cities and towns. It also funds training programs for coaches, prints instruction materials, renovates sports facilities and takes top coaches and students on trips to visit professional football clubs in England, the Netherlands and Spain. In 2006, the Academy of Football took over the administration of the Konoplyov Football Academy at Primorsky, near Tulyatti, Samara Oblast, where over 1,000 youths are in residence, following the death at 38 of its founder, Yuri Konoplev. Chapter 7, Wealth. According to Forbes, as of March 2016, Abramovich had a net worth of $7.6 billion, ranking him as the 155th richest person in the world. Prior to the 2008 financial crisis, he was considered to be the second richest person living within the United Kingdom. Early in 2009, The Times estimated that due to the global economic crisis he had lost £3 billion from his £11.7 billion wealth. On 5 March 2021, Forbes listed his net worth at $14.6 billion, ranking him 113 on the Billionaire's 2020 Forbes list. Chapter 7, Section 1, Wealth Rankings. Chapter 7, Section 2, Charitable Donations. Abramovich has reportedly donated more money to charity than any other living Russian. Between 2009 and 2013, Abramovich donated more than $2.5 billion to build schools, hospitals and infrastructure in Chukotka. In addition, Evraz PLC, the steelmaker partly owned by Abramovich, donated $164 million for social projects between 2010 through 2012, an amount that is excluded in Abramovich's $310 million donations during this period. Abramovich has reportedly spent approximately £1.5 billion on the Pole of Hope, his charity set up to help those in the Arctic region of Chukotka, where he was governor. In June 2019, Abramovich donated $5 million to the Jewish Agency for Israel, to support efforts to combat antisemitism globally. Chapter 8, Other Interests and Activities. Chapter 8, Section 1, Art. Abramovich sponsored an exhibition of photographs of Uzbekistan by renowned Soviet photographer Max Penson, which opened on 29 November 2006 at the Gilbert Collection at Somerset House in London. He previously funded the exhibition Quiet Resistance, Russian Pictorial Photography 1900s-1930s at the same gallery in 2005. Both exhibits were organized by the Moscow House of Photography. In May 2008, Abramovich emerged as a major buyer in the international art auction market. He purchased Francis Bacon's triptych 1976 for €61.4 million and Lucian Freud's Benefits Supervisor Sleeping for €23.9 million. His partner Dasha Zhukova is managing a Garage Center for Contemporary Culture, gallery of contemporary art in Moscow that was initially housed in the historical Bakometevsky Bus Garage building by Konstantin Melnikov. The building, neglected for decades and partially taken apart by previous tenants, was restored in 2007 to 2008 and reopened to the public in September 2008. Speed and expensive restoration is credited to sponsorship by Abramovich. Chapter 8, Section 2, Yachts. Abramovich has become the world's greatest spender on luxury yachts, and always maintains a fleet of yachts which the media have called Abramovich's navy, current boats. Eclipse 162.5 meters, built in Germany by Blom plus Voss, she was launched in September 2009. Abramovich was due to take delivery of the yacht in December 2009, but was delayed for almost a year after extensive sea trials. The yacht's interior and exterior were designed by Terence de Stael. Eclipse is believed to have cost Abramovich around $400 million and was the world's largest privately owned yacht until it was eclipsed in 2013 by the 180 meters Azam. The specification includes at least two swimming pools, a cinema, two helicopter landing pads, several onboard tenders and a submarine that can be launched and dive to a depth of 160 feet. She is also equipped with armor plating surrounding the bridge and Abramovich's master suite, as well as bulletproof windows. Former boats. Polaris 115 meters, built by Lursen for Sheikh Abdul Mohsen Abdul Malik al-Sheikh in 2003, original owner of MY Coral Island and MY Sasuro, who received six offers to sell her before she was even completed. The Sheikh accepted the highest bid, which was Abramovich. The interior was designed by Terence de Stael. The exterior was designed by Tim Haywood. Polaris was refitted by Blom plus Voss in 2005, adding a new forward helipad and zero-speed stabilizers. Given to Irina in 2009 as part of the divorce settlement, she was approached on David Geffen's behalf by broker Merle Wood, with Geffen paying $300 million to take ownership in 2011. Sasuro 49.5 meters, built by Fedship in 1998 for Sheikh Abdul Mohsen Abdul Malik al-Sheikh. Ecstasy 85 meters, largest Fedship, built at launch in 2004 for Abramovich. She has a gas turbine alongside the conventional diesels, which gives her high cruising speed. Abramovich sold the boat to the Alnayan family in 2009. The Grand Blur 112 meters, formerly owned by John McCaw, Abramovich bought the expedition yacht in 2003 and had her completely refitted by Blom plus Voss, including a 16-foot swim platform and sports dock. He presented her as a gift to his associate and friend Eugene Schidler in June 2006. Luna 115 meters, built by Lloyd Werft and delivered to Roman Abramovich in 2009 as an upgraded replacement for his Le Grand Bleu expedition yacht. Sold to close friend, Azerbaijani-born billionaire Farkad Akhmedov, in April 2014 for $360 million. Boasts a 1-million-litre fuel tank, 7 engines outputting 15,000 horsepower, propelling Luna to a maximum speed of 25 knots, 8 tenders, 15 centimeters ice-class steel hull and 10 VIP cabins. Chapter 8 Section 3, Aircraft. Abramovich owns a private Boeing 767-33A/ER, registered in Aruba's P4 May. It is known as the Bandit due to its livery. Originally the aircraft was ordered by Hawaiian Airlines, but the order was cancelled and Abramovich bought it from Boeing and refitted it to his own requirements by Andrew Winch, who designed the interior and exterior. The aircraft was estimated in 2016 to cost $300 million, and its interior is reported to include a 30-seat dining room, a boardroom, master bedrooms, luxury bathrooms with showers, and a spacious living room. The aircraft has the same air missile avoidance system as Air Force One. Chapter 8 Section 4, St. Bartholomew New Year's Eve Celebrations. In 2011, Abramovich hired the Red Hot Chili Peppers to perform at his estate in Bay de Governor in St. Barth for a reported £5 million. The performance by Red Hot Chili Peppers included a special appearance from Toots Hibbert of Toots and the Maytals. Abramovich reportedly spent £5 million on a total of 300 guests, including George Lucas, Martha Stewart, Marc Jacobs, and Jimmy Buffett. In 2014, Abramovich hired British singer Robbie Williams to headline a New Year's dinner for President Putin's inner circle. The party took place in Moscow and appears to have been the inspiration for Williams' song Party Like a Russian. Chapter 8, Section 5, Israeli Citizenship. In May 2018, Abramovich became an Israeli citizen a month after the UK delayed renewing his visa. Following the poisoning of Sergei and Yulia Skripal, British authorities delayed the renewal of his visa, as tensions rose between the UK and Russia. Abramovich had been travelling in and out of the UK for years on a Tier 1 investor visa, designed for wealthy foreigners who invest at least £2 million in Britain. Abramovich, who is Russian-Jewish, exercised his right under Israel's law of return, which states that Jews from anywhere in the world can become citizens of Israel. As an Israeli, Abramovich can now visit Britain visa-free but not permitted to work or conduct business transactions. Abramovich owns the Varsano Boutique Hotel in Tel Aviv's Neve Tzedek neighborhood, which he bought for 100 million new Israeli shekels in 2015 from Gal Gadot's husband Yaron Varsano, and Varsano's brother Guy. In January 2020, Abramovich purchased a property in Herzliya Pituah for a record 226 new Israeli shekels million. Abramovich has also invested in more than a dozen Israeli startups, including rapid battery charger technology developer Stordot. In 2018, he donated 70 million new Israeli shekels for the Sheba Hospital in Tel HaShoma for nuclear medicine research. Chapter 8, Section 6, Attempted Residency in Switzerland. In 2016, Abramovich applied for residency in Switzerland, intending to move to the ski resort of Verbier. Swiss authorities denied the application after the Swiss Federal Office of Police concluded that Abramovich was under suspicion of money laundering and presumed contacts with criminal organizations, and that his assets were at least partially of illegal origin. Abramovich unsuccessfully took legal action to prevent Swiss media from reporting on the matter, and denied the allegations. Chapter 8, Section 7, Mega Mansion in New York City. Abramovich purchased for $74 million and is combining four Upper East Side townhouses in Manhattan in New York City into a mega mansion, 9, 11, 13, and 15 East 75th Street. The combined mega mansion will be 19,400 square feet, and it is estimated that renovation costs will be an additional $100 million.